Got a rhythm in my heart and in my soul. Got a reason for this joy I can't control. I wanna sing, I wanna dance, and give everyone a chance to hear about this endless love I know. What you give to me is not for me to keep, it's for the world to see your love. Shine, you make me glow. You pick me up when I am feeling low. I wanna sing, I wanna dance, and give everyone a chance to hear about this endless love I know. What you give to me is not for me to keep, it's for the world to see your love.
Slow down, I'm gonna trust that. got you working it out.
Bon appetit, everyone. My name is Graham. I'm dressed like this because I want to know what it feels like to be a real chef. I want to be able to bake a cake that's as tall as me. I want to make chocolate chip cookies that are so gooey the chocolate stretches a full 6 feet. I want to understand what fondant is. Fondant? Fondant? I want to be able to say the word fondant. But like most things in life, becoming a real chef takes time. It takes patience. Patience is waiting until later for what you want now. And I know a thing or two about patience. I signed up for a baking class 6 weeks ago that wasn't supposed to start until today. So I have to wait. And today I found out that the class has been postponed for another 2 weeks because our teacher is sick. It looks like she's going to be okay, but still, I have to wait some more.
So now I'm wondering, what if I never get to go to class? What if it gets postponed again and again and again? What if it stays this way
forever?
The longer I have to wait, the harder it gets. If only there was some way to make the waiting not feel so hard. Maybe there is a way. In today's story, we'll learn about a guy named Simeon who had to wait a long time for God to keep his promise.
But Simeon didn't have to wait alone.
So, I guess I'll see you soon. I'll just wait here. Oh man, I could really go for one of those gooey chocolate chip cookies right about now. Chocolate.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how he created us and loves us so much that he made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Luke, chapter 2, verses 25. Through 35.
The birth of Jesus was unusual in many ways. He entered the world in a shelter with the animals and was celebrated by an entire host of angels.
Glory to God in the highest.
But Mary and Joseph cared for Jesus as with any child. When he was about 6 weeks old, they prepared to present him to the Lord at the temple.
The law says we must offer a sacrifice of two pigeons.
Or doves. How is he 6 weeks old already?
But as Mary and Joseph set out for Jerusalem with their firstborn son, someone was already waiting for them. A man named Simeon, and their stories were about to collide. Simeon had grown up in Jerusalem, faithfully worshiping God. He prayed daily.
Lord, help me understand your law. Help me serve you with my whole life.
Simeon would have studied the scriptures, words from the prophets from hundreds of years before.
The people who are now living in darkness will see a great light. They are now living in a very dark land, but a light will shine on them. What light, Lord?
Over the years, Simeon continued to pray, to worship, and to seek God in the temple. God's Holy Spirit was with him. And one day, the Spirit made Simeon a promise.
You will not die before you see the Lord's Messiah.
Me? With my own eyes? Thank you, Lord.
Simeon believed the promise and waited in joyful expectation.
Will it be today, Lord?
Simeon waited some more.
Will it be this year, Lord?
And then he waited still more.
How about this decade?
We aren't quite sure how long Simeon had to wait, but when his hair turned snow white, he was still waiting.
Soon, Lord.
Today, at last, Simeon received a new response.
The temple courtyard? I'm on my way. Where's my cloak? My walking stick?
God's Spirit led Simeon straight up to the Temple Mount and into the courtyard. Simeon stood in the center of the courtyard, allowing the voices to wash around him. He wasn't quite sure what he was looking for, but he knew God would reveal it to him.
A baby?
Simeon turned quickly to see a young couple nearby. The man carried a pair of doves in a small cage, the usual sacrifice after a child was born. The woman cradled a tiny baby in her arms.
Joseph, where do we go?
Excuse me.
Both the man and the woman looked up quickly.
May I hold the child?
Well, all right, yes.
Simeon took the child gently into his arms. In the eyes of this infant, he saw the face of God. The rescuer, God's promised Messiah.
His name is Jesus.
Overwhelmed, Simeon turned his gaze toward heaven.
Lord, you are the King over all. Now let me, your servant, go in peace. That is what you promised. My eyes have seen your salvation. You have prepared it in the sight of all nations. It is a light to be given to the Gentiles. It will be the glory of your people, Israel.
Mary and Joseph stared in amazement.
We knew he was special.
This.
Simeon looked down at the child, then glanced up at Mary and Joseph again.
May the Lord bless you both.
Gently, Simeon returned Jesus to his mother's arms. After a lifetime of waiting, Simeon was overjoyed to see the fulfillment of the promise God had given him so long ago.
We don't know for sure how long Simeon had to wait before he got to see Jesus, but it's possible he had to wait for years. We usually don't have to wait years for something to happen, but sometimes when we're waiting, it can feel like years. Sometimes it can feel like
forever, ever, 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 ever.
Like when you're waiting for your birthday or Christmas, or when you're waiting to feel better while you're sick. I know it's hard to wait, but here's the good news. You don't have to wait alone. God is with you. He knows what you're going through. He knows what the whole world is going through, and he knows how it will all turn out. So talk to God. Put your trust in him. He's going to be with you through everything. In fact, God will be with you forever. So, that's the one thing to remember today. When you have to wait, remember God is with you. I still have to wait for my first baking class. Maybe it'll happen in 2 weeks, maybe longer. But no matter what, I won't be waiting alone. God will be with me. I'll see you next time. Hopefully I'll have some gooey chocolate chip cookies for us to try by then. I wonder if the goo will stretch from me to you. I can't wait to find out. See you then.